We're here at Kiel Golf Centre with TG Test Pro Neil Wayne, and we're talking about the best tour golf balls of 2021. And we know in the past, Neil, that we've done a robot test which has done this for us. But there's 10 new models of tour ball out there, and we felt it was only fair to be able to show you how each of the new models compares. And to me, it really feels like this category may be a little bit less relevant than it has been in some previous years. And that's because there's been lots of club golfer golf balls that have been launched just at the average speed player out there, you know. So where we know that all of these golf balls, they're winning the big bucks out there on tour, actually, it's really important to the average club golfer at home to really make up their mind which golf ball suits them. And we know the average speed, you know, for a driver is about 93 miles an hour. Yeah. So if you're below that, then you really should be looking at those club golfer balls that are aimed at your specific swing speed. They're the things like the TaylorMade Tour Response, the Srixon Q-Star Tour, the Callaway-Chrome-Soft, you know, there's plenty of them. The Titleist, the Tour Speed.
Yeah.
But at the same time, we know that there are some pretty good players that really want to know how all these 10 models compare.
And I think it's also worth mentioning, Sam, that we're going to tidy up a few myths. I do this with a wedge, I need to use that golf ball, I do this with a 72. It's not, they don't all marry up, do they? So, which we'll cover in a second. So definitely some interesting results, guys, that we want to cover with you.
Okay, let's get started then, just by running through what the brands say about each of the golf balls in this category, and we'll try to help you sort of pick the models that might be most relevant to your game. I'm really hoping this isn't too new to most people that would be buying tour golf balls, but just really quickly, run us through the different constructions, because there's many different ones.
Yeah, you can see there, guys, obviously you've got your three-piece construction, four-piece construction, and TaylorMade are in at the party with a five-piece construction golf ball, so seems quite technical for me. But just as a broad category, guys, just because it's a tour golf ball doesn't mean that they're all the same construction.
Okay, it's probably just worthwhile just pointing out that over here, it tends to be your softer balls, whereas in the four-piece it goes to your firmer balls. And then obviously at the end you've got TaylorMade, the TP5, which has got softer and firmer. But the TaylorMade would say that the five layers really gives them the chance to twiddle knobs and gauges to be able to just affect performance slightly more than what a three or a four-piece golf ball would do. Okay, so if we just move on then, Neil, just to looking at trying to give you some information about how you should be choosing between the different golf balls, because this is what the brands are actually saying about them.
Yeah, and it's very good really what the brands have done, isn't it, Simon? So the guys can get a rough idea of what sort of route that they're going down, because a lot of guys do have an idea of firmer and softer feeling golf balls, what they swing the driver speed at, what they swing the 7-iron club head speed at. So you can get this really dialed in really to optimize to help your golf game.
Okay, so what I would really say on the TaylorMade is I love the way that when they launched them in 2017, they said to anybody that, you know, wasn't too interested about the data, you know, and choosing between them, just choose a golf ball on the feel that you want. So if you want it slightly softer, play the TP5. If you like something that's a little bit firmer, play the TP5x. Yeah. And that's really, really good advice, which you'll see later in the data.
Yeah.
The data doesn't always give you the whole picture, so the feel does really play a part. Just moving on to Srixon. This I absolutely love. This is a Srixon graphic. Just talk us through it.
Yeah, really, I'm impressed by this probably. Over most of the brands, I mean, that's really clever what they've done there. Based on whether you swing over 105 mile an hour or do you swing over 90 mile an hour, those are the two main categories. And you can just filter your way through there, whether you prefer the softer feel, the firmer. Does a youth rain cover come into it? Obviously, if you go that way, then you tend to a little bit more price range. But that's really, really clever there. You can really get that and straight to the golf ball that you perform, that's going to perform best for you. Get out on the golf course with it and give it a go.
Okay, and as we've already touched on, if the average swing for a club golfer is 93 miles an hour, if you've got the Z Star that's aimed at over 90 mile an hour swing speed, should you really be playing with a premium tour level golf ball? That's a choice that only you can really make. Yeah. If you're over 105 miles an hour, then you should be looking at the Z Star XV, like Shane Lowry. On to Titleist, Titleist Pro V1, Pro V1X, Neil.
Yeah, they've kind of switched up a little bit over the years, haven't they, Simon? It used to be the V1 would be high launch, higher spin, and steeper descent angle with all clubs in the bag. Pro V1X would be your lower launch, lower spin, firmer feel. They're kind of like switching roles a little bit. You tend to, the Pro V1X is still firmer feeling, but it's not necessarily lower spinning. So again, it's important that the guys probably play around with both, and because they do feel different, definitely off the face.
Okay, and probably worthwhile just pointing out that Titleist say that a vast majority of golfers, they will fit into the Pro V1. In my own eyes, the way that I would see the difference between them is the X just flies a bit higher, and it's not as penetrating as what you would get with the Pro V1. Just moving on then to the Wilson, so the staff model. This is a really interesting golf ball.
Yeah.
It's not about choosing between the two of them because one's painted, one's unpainted. But a really good idea about that when a golf ball's painted, you can get pooling in the dimples.
Yeah.
And really, really so important not that. To have that.
Yeah, really impressive that, Simon, about looking at, like, when they look at the golf ball under a black light, the unpainted ball, how there's, like, inconsistent paint coverage, which can have an effect in the flight of the golf ball. Mm-hmm. Never really thought about that. That's really clever.
So if you do get pooling in a dimple, it's very much like an aeroplane that flies with ice on its wing. So it's got more weight on one side, so it'll fly towards that side.
Clever stuff.
So really, really good idea. Okay, and last but not least, Callaway. Really interesting lineup of golf balls from the Chrome Soft X, Chrome Soft XLS, and they're all aimed at very, very different players, Neil.
Yeah, but again, fair play to Callaway. Regardless of what standard you're at or what you're looking for, then there's a golf ball out there for you. And you can see your Chrome Soft, you tend to get probably a little bit higher spin, higher launch, softer feeling. Chrome Soft X probably falls to your guy that swings a little
it's
bit
workable,
faster.
Isn't it?
Workable. Yeah. Maybe a little bit, see that it's mid launch, so it's actually lower launching than the Chrome Soft. Mm-hmm. And then straight into the Chrome Soft XLS. So you're looking for the less spin, but they've still got the firmer feel in there. Probably a higher swing speed probably fall into that category.
Absolutely. What Callaway say themselves is, if you're swinging at less than 100 miles an hour, then you should be looking at the Chrome Soft. If you're swinging at more than 105, then you've got the choice between the Chrome Soft X and the Chrome Soft XLS. If you're in the middle between 100 and 105, then you need to choose what's really important to your own game. Okay, that's loads of information there. Let's move on and have a look at how each of the golf balls compares when using a driver. Everybody wants distance. If you say that you don't, then you must be lying. And this is how each of the balls performed with Neil's driver. So you swing the golf club at about 112 miles
an
hour?
Yeah, about 112 on an average, I'd say, Simon, definitely. I could probably crank you up a little bit more chasing it, but obviously lose a bit of impact location if I do.
So just looking at raw numbers, there's one standout performer there.
Yeah, right, Callaway Chrome Soft XLS. I've 282 carry, I'm very pleased with that. So definitely a performer.
Okay, so just to be clear, it's only 2 yards out in front, but let's just take a little bit of a deeper dive into what the numbers actually mean. It's actually a really close call. There's only 9 yards between the longest and the shortest ball. And so that means they're pretty well matched. The firmer style X balls were nearly a mile an hour faster and 3.2 yards longer. So there is a difference there.
Yeah.
If you're chasing every yard of distance, you've got to be looking at X balls.
Yeah, if you've got the speed, definitely. And fair play to the manufacturers who've said that the X-type style golf balls are a little bit longer with the driver, and they've come up on top on the testing, haven't they?
Okay, if you're looking for a ball that performs at both ends of the bag, which a lot of people are, there are two standout performers, which we'll come back to on wedges a little bit later. But the Wilson staff model and the Titleist Pro V1X as well, they do perform with the driver and with the wedge extremely well.
I like the feel of those two as well.
We talk about speed and spin lots and lots in the modern game, Neil, but neither the fastest or the lowest spin ball were actually longest.
Yeah, you've got to be careful of that, especially if the guys are using a lower spin driver, Simon. Mm-hmm. If you've got that weight forward, wouldn't necessarily combine that with a lower spinning golf ball. Like myself, that I use the Ping G410 driver, for instance, quite a high spinning driver, as we know, but the low spinning golf ball has actually produced the best numbers for us, hasn't it? So that combination probably works well for I do.
So you're looking for optimal across the board, aren't you? You have to look at what driver you use and team that up with the correct golf ball to go with it.
Yeah.
Okay, and if there is a standout performer, we've already touched on it, that Callaway Chrome Soft XLS is it's only 2 yards, but if you're chasing every single distance from the tee, then it's a really, really good performer.
Yeah, it's the one to look at, guys. If you've got the speed, the club head speed, definitely give it a go if you're looking to drop bombs, as they say.
Okay, let's move on and have a look at irons. In exactly the same way as the drivers were very closely matched on data, the irons are pretty very closely matched, Neil, as well.
Yeah, 7 yards there, Sam, between the longest and the shortest. That's hardly any difference, is there, really?
Okay, just tell us about the longest balls there, because there's a couple of them.
So you can see there, 172 from my traditional lofted 7-iron. It's pretty long, that. That's Srixon-Z-Star-XV and the Wilson Staff R model, both good performers there. Decent spin numbers as well, that, really.
Okay, and there's only a yard between the top 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 balls, so there's nothing in it, you know, and that could change on another day of testing.
Yeah,
as well.
Definitely, yeah.
So let's just move on then, just to sort of go through the category. And 7 yards has covered off all 10 golf balls.
Yeah.
And the X style balls were just a single yard longer, so there's not too much in it.
Yeah,
like
when you come
to the
irons, it's definitely a little bit closer there, Simon, between the two styles of golf ball over what there was with the drive, a bit more of a gap, wasn't there?
Okay, so if you look at the performance between the X-style balls and the standard ball from each range, there's 3 to 7 yards difference combining the driver and the 7-iron distance. Between the TaylorMade, the Srixon and the Titleist, between the firmer and the softer balls. But it's 15 yards with the Callaways. Mm. So there's a real choice to be made between the LS and the standard Chrome-Soft X.
You can. I feel like if you're looking to hit it longer, and you've got off decent speeds, that chrome
with,
soft
with
LS,
driver and irons.
Yeah, chrome soft LS is definitely a golf ball that needs to be tested, guys.
Okay, and there's quite a few golfers out there that we've heard that have said that spin equals control. If that's what it really means to you, okay, there's a great performer here right in the middle, because the Wilson Staff model and the Staff model R, they were the only two balls to record over 6,800 RPM of backspin with the 7-iron, and no other balls did. So that's
that's a good little stat there, Sam, really. Again, a golf ball that guys that are watching should probably test and put it on, maybe on the golf course, give it a try.
Really think about the flight window that you want, because you really prefer slightly higher, slightly hanging ball flight.
Yeah, definitely. You've got to hit those windows, haven't you, from your own, and that's why it's important to see the ball flight. So you do maybe some on-course testing with them as well, guys, to see if you can hit that window there.
Okay, and you really like to see it just like a hanging ball flight. That's how I would describe it.
Yeah, definitely. Peak out around about that 32, 33, 34 yards, as where I'd want to be, Sam.
But you can really change that depending on the ball that you choose, you know, so really, really pay attention to what you want from your ball flight as well.
Yeah.
So if there is a standout performer then with the irons, the Srixon-Z-Star-XV is pretty good with the driver and the irons.
Yeah, I've never really considered using a Srixon golf ball, but for how that's performed there, very, very good. Felt good as well. But I think there's a standout performer for distance over the two, isn't that? We can't look past that Chrome Soft XLS that's long with combination with both, isn't it, Simon? Driver and 7-iron.
Yeah, okay, so that's a lot to digest there. Let's move on and have a look at how all the balls compared with a wedge. Wedge performance. We've heard it a million times before, Neil, that people choose a golf ball because they think it spins more with a wedge.
Yeah.
That isn't always what you expect it to be.
No, I think the thing, the biggest myth bust that we can do here, Simon, is the guys that get carried away with the softer golf ball always spins the most with the wedge. Mm-hmm. They tend to spin the most with your green side shots. So anything pitching, chipping, anything up to like those 30 yard shots. When you're hitting those longer golf shots, at my kind of speeds anyway, when you're hitting those 120, 130 yard wedge shots, you tend to find the X style golf balls tend to spin a little bit more.
And we've seen exactly the same thing when we did the robot golf balls test back in 2019. The firmer style golf balls, when you're hitting a full wedge, they do spin more than the softer models. A really nice way that I like to really think about it is that think of a softer golf ball creating more spin where you can't have a full swing. That's those green side areas. Yeah. You know, it's going to give you a little bit more spin there, but not when you're hitting a full wedge from 110 yards or further away. So just talk us through these, because there's some pretty interesting numbers up there.
Well, you can see there straight away, Simon, that the X models there, the TP5 obviously is top the board, mm-hmm. and the Titleist Pro V1X, so the 2X golf balls that we'd expect to be probably, in terms of the myth busting, they'd be lower spinning with the wedge, are actually been quite high. That Wilson Staff R model's been quite a good performer.
Across the board, isn't it?
Yeah, definitely, across all three categories.
Okay, so let's just see if we can tell the whole story. Longest to lowest spin. Okay, so the Callaway-Chrome-Soft XLS.
Yeah.
Brilliant driver.
Fantastic from the driver.
Brilliant iron.
Yeah, fantastic with the driver. Long, low spinning. With the iron, long. But then really lower spinning with the wedge, and not necessarily any longer. So sometimes you've got to think about, now this is a scoring game, like what you've got to put a little bit of something on the line when you lean towards the longer golf ball, haven't you?
Yeah, and we sort of talk about it like it's a big difference. We're talking an 800 RPM difference. It's not huge.
Yeah, it's tiny.
You know? So it's really about weighing up what's important to you. Is it driver distance or is it short game spin?
Yeah.
That will make up your mind around that ball.
Feel would be a big thing as well.
Yeah, okay, brilliant. So is there a best all-rounder? That Wilson Staff model, that has done pretty well across the board.
Across the board, yeah, very good.
So if you can give up 3 yards against the very longest driver ball and 4 yards against the longest iron ball, then the Staff model rewards you with virtually the same levels of wedge spin as our very best ball. And that's a very, very good
combination. It's a little bit cheaper than the Pro V1 and the TP5. Both models, so it's if budget's in mind, then it's definitely worth considering.
Okay, we're arguing about 850 RPM of backspin of a wedge.
It's not huge,
here.
Is it?
We've seen it before. You know, it just feels like such a premium that elite golfers put on a softer feeling golf ball. From what we've seen, at the end of the day, that you lose at both ends of your bag. So you lose it with the driver, but you also lose them when you're hitting full wedge shots. It's only for those very shortest shots that you actually gain from them.
Yeah, I think the trend on tour with the guys going more towards the X style golf ball speaks volumes, doesn't it, really?
Yeah, so you have got the likes of Tommy Fleetwood and Rory, you know, in response to Bryson DeChambeau, what he's doing, just erring back to the side, you know, of the X balls, because they just want that little bit of extra ball speed, that little bit of extra distance, whatever they can get their hands on. And it's worth getting that if you can afford to lose just a little bit of tiny spin from very short areas in the game.
Yeah.
Okay, moving on to standout performer. Okay, so the TP5, the TaylorMade. We've sung its praises before. It's been a great golf ball, but the eagle-eyed viewers out there, they might well have seen that the TP5 and TP5x numbers don't quite sort of stack up. The data doesn't always tell the story that it needs to.
No, it's important, really, that you get these golf balls, guys. You're going to test them as well and put them in all different kinds of conditions, like, obviously, to see what they do in the wind, when you're out on the golf course. So see if, like we've touched on before, Simon, see if you can hit those windows of the ball flight that you necessarily want to hit. I know we can give optimum numbers in terms of and the high spin, the highest ball speed, but you've got to do what you want the golf ball want it to do as well.
Yeah, and it's just that data. You know, if you look back, the TP5 with the driver and the iron, the TP5 is actually faster and longer than what the TP5X is, which isn't really what you'd expect. But bear in mind, this is just for one golfer. This is just for Neil.
Yeah.
And data just doesn't always.
And it's only on one day, isn't it, as well?
Yes.
This could vary from day to day, really.
Okay, and the final thing, there's bound to be a ton of questions. Why are Bridgestone not involved in this test? Well, pretty much, the Bridgestone are not really available here in the UK. They don't have a distributor, so we're not able to get hold of their golf balls. That's exactly why they're not involved in this test. Okay, you've got a ton of information there. If you've liked the video, hit the like and subscribe button. And if you've got any comments or questions, leave them below, and we promise to answer every single sensible one. We'll see you next time.